I'm glad to see you again. This is Bruno's second class. This is our puppy class. Let me turn on Instagram. Hello, my Instagram friends. We are here at Lucky Pet, recording live. This is our second puppy class for Bruno. And what I would like you to do at home is follow these videos with your puppy. It doesn't have to be at the same time as I'm recording it, but you can follow it at home if you're avoiding to go to public places or anywhere else. On the first class, we practiced watch me and we practiced place. And we did some puppy massage in the first class. So we're gonna review what we did in the first class. And today we're gonna start with the walking position basics. And I call it the walking position because I don't start walking dogs on a leash in the first class. I like to start with them. I like to teach them where I expect them to be when I say the word walk. And I'm going to explain some more about that. I call it the walking foundation, that's how I call it. And that's very practical when you have when you're starting to walk a puppy, or if you have an adult dog that pulls you a lot, this is a great exercise to start with. And the second thing we're gonna do today is, the second exercise we're gonna do is how to brush your dog properly. Bruno is a doodle. I have to confess, I tried brushing him on Tuesday when he came here to Lucky Pet on Tuesday, and he didn't like it at all. So you'll see him. It's good because you'll see how to brush a puppy that doesn't like to be brushed. So if you have a puppy at home that does like the brush, you have extra points for you. So let's get started. Hey Bruno! Today we're gonna use the pocket trainers. Let me show you. These are the Bixby pocket trainers. I don't know if you see them well. And you can find them in our webpage. It's luckypetusa.com, or you can come to Lucky Pet. We're in Tampa. If you're anywhere in US, please support your local business, your local pet store. Local pet stores are awesome. At least here, we love to explain, we love to talk with people, we love to talk about dogs. It is a whole different experience. So, I think Bruno is ready to work. So let's start by reviewing. Let's do place. In the first class, we explained that place is like teaching your dog to go into a certain place, spot, as if it was the crate, but without all the crate stuff on it. Let me put this. Here we go. Okay, Bruno, place. And what we expect at this time for place, you see here, he sat on the towel, but he doesn't have his four paws on the towel. Off. Off, Bruno. Good boy. We talked about the timing for the rewards in the first class as well. So if this is your first time watching these videos, I would suggest you place. Good boy. Place, Bruno. Place. As simple as that. What we expect is for him to have his four paws on the towel when we tell him place. Good boy, Bruno. If he stays on place, that's perfect. Place. Good boy. Maybe he's not recognizing the difference between sit and place, but I will reward him because eventually that will click. Bruno. Bruno, place. You see? Yeah, I think he thinks place is sit. Bruno, Bruno, place. Good boy. Timing. I told him good boy as soon as his four paws got on the towel. If he leaves one paw out of the towel, then I won't reward him. Good boy, Bruno. And if he stays on the towel for a while, then extra points for him, more treats. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Okay, the second command we worked on Tuesday was, let me see if I can do a close-up, because I want you to see. It's fine, I think you'll see it from here. Was watch me. practicing watch me for a full week, and he knows what I expect from him. I'm gonna wait a bit longer just to have a longer watch me. Bruno, watch me. Good boy. Watch. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. You see how patient he is? If you look at the first video, he was not that patient. He just wanted that treat for free. Bruno, watch me. Watch me. Good boy. I think I forgot to mention on the first day of class, when you start training your puppy, he will start working for everything in his life. He will not receive anything for free from then on. What does that mean? If you're going to feed him, if you're going to pet him, anything you're going to give to him, he has to win it. So make him sit, make him watch you, give him a command. And that will be the common language between you and the dog. And that bonding, I mean, dog, it sounds like cruel, but it's not. They do love to work, and they feel important when they know what you expect from them. Bruno, watch me. Watch me, good boy. Watch, good boy. Watch me, good boy. Watch me, good boy. One thing that might happen to be aware at home, usually they do, like you saw Bruno, they watch and they look at the hand, watch and they look. Be careful not to tell them good boy or give them the treat when they look at the hands. Because if not, if you do tell them good boy when they look at the hand, that's what they will think that watch me is. Watch me. Good boy, watch me. Good boy. Okay, perfect. So I think he's doing pretty good with his two puppy commands. Good boy for me, Ronnie. Good boy. Okay, so let's start by walking. When I do private lessons, I start working on the walking foundation with the puppy off leash or with the dog off leash, okay? And I'm gonna show you first what I do, and then I'll explain some more, okay? Bruno, walk. Bruno, walk. Good boy, Bruno. Let me take the towel out of the towel. Off, Bruno. Off. Good boy, Bruno. Nice. Let's put this away. Okay, Bruno. So, for this command, he will be praised every time he is by my side. His face should be at my leg's level, okay? Bruno, walk. Walk. And he will start trying to decide for what I expect from him. I'm not going to help him that much. Because part of the fun of working is them trying to discover what I want from them. So it'll make the, once he gets it, he does that, it'll be more fun for him, for them. Bruno, walk. Bruno, walk. Walk. Good boy, Bruno, good boy. You see, I really bend down and I give him the treat when his face, let me see, is by my leg. I don't give him the treat if he crosses me. I will not give him a treat. I will not tell him good boy. Bruno, walk. Walk. Good boy, Bruno, good boy. Walk. Walk, Bruno. Good boy, Bruno. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Bruno, walk. Bruno, walk. Good boy, Bruno. Walk. Good boy. You see, I'm not praising him for walking. I'm praising him for reaching, for coming to my side. Okay, Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Bruno, walk. Good boy, Bruno, good boy. walk. Bruno. Walk, Bruno. So cute, I should give him the treat, but I'm not. Bruno, walk. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Good boy. Bruno, walk. Walk. Good boy. Walk, Bruno. Walk. Good boy. I know it's easier to feed him with my left hand, but I like to use my right hand because sometimes they start smelling my hand. I want to be able to keep my arms relaxed by my side when I start walking with them. Bruno, walk. Yes, good boy, good boy. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Good boy, Bruno, good boy. You see, even baby steps, that counts as a walk. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Good boy, Bruno, good boy. Bruno, walk. Good boy, good boy. Yes, good boy. He sits. Extra points for him. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Walk, Bruno. He doesn't understand what walk means, so he's trying to understand what it is. So he knows sit, so he'll sit. Good boy, Bruno, walk. Good boy. And he'll stare at me because he knows watch me. But with walk, this is the first time he ever listens to that word. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Walk. Walk. Good boy, you see? It's amazing how they start learning and understanding the commands. Walk, Bruno. Yes, good boy. All the way around. Bruno, walk. Good boy. Sit. Yes, good boy. Bruno, watch me. Watch me. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. You see how you start linking all the commands. Bruno, walk. Walk, Bruno. Walk. Bruno, walk. Good boy. Sit. Bruno, sit. Yes, good boy. Bruno, watch me. Good boy. Watch me. Watch me. Good boy. Yes, good boy, Bruno. Let's see, Bruno. Let me bring the cameras closer. He loves a towel. Let's see if he wants to play tough today. Okay, good boy, Bruno. Yes, good boy. Okay, this is not on the plans, but if he wants to play tough, that's a very healthy exercise for them. As long as you always use anything that's not any body part, or and that you have control over it. You will let him know when he can grab the toy and when he needs to leave it. Bruno, take it. Good boy, Bruno, take it. Yes, good boy, Bruno, take it. And if your puppy's teething, this is a great exercise, right? No, not the towel, Bruno. Bruno, take it. Enjoy this exercise, which is very healthy for puppies. So I'm gonna move the phone closer to the, let's see if this works. Thank you for watching and thank you for your patience. We're good at training, but not with technology, so. We do the best we can. Let's see. There we go. I just want you to be closer to... That's not your toy, Bruno. I just want you to be closer to the towel because I'm going to start brushing him and I really want you to see what's happening there. Okay, Bruno. Let's leave it. Make sure you have enough treats in your pocket. I like to use these, oh my God, this is my favorite treat bag. It's Duke brand. Of course, you can get it at luckypetusa.com or at your local pet store. Please support your local pet store. We highly appreciate it. And I'll put a link to all the information on the comments later on. Okay, let's leave that. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Thank you. Your dog are a comb and a slicker brush. Some people are afraid of slicker brush because it seems like very hard for the skin, but if you use it correctly, it will not harm the skin of the dog. In fact, the dog's skin is much, how do you say that word? Not tougher, I would say, than ours, okay? So, let me see. Make sure you have a treat. If it's a puppy like Bruno, he doesn't like the brush or the comb. Good boy, let him smell it. Good boy, Bruno. Yes, good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Okay. Maybe sit him on your lap. Good boy, Bruno, Bruno. Yes, good boy. Give him treats there. Good boy, Bruno. Good thing about Bruno. never ever had a bad experience with a brush or a comb. It's just something that some dogs like to be brushed, others don't. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Let's see if we can get him to relax a bit. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. And I'm gonna try just one paw with him. So you're gonna. Yes, yes, yes. Good boy. You're gonna comb him. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Important that you start the grooming process with your puppy at a very young age, because the dogs with long hair, especially doodles, shih tzus, maltese, they do need grooming, and you want them to get used to it, because as good as a grooming will be, it's not their environment, and it's always going to be a stress, a little bit of stress for the dog. So you might as well. Good boy. Bruno's not mad at all. I just want him to get used to the comb. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Good boy. Oh, no. He said no. Yes, good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Wanna try it again? Good boy, Bruno. Come on, boy. Come on. Good boy, Bruno. and by next week, he should be used to it. Good boy, Bruno. Ideally, I will be holding him with my left hand and brushing him with the right hand. I'll use the comb first, make sure he's not matted, and then I use the slicker brush. And that applies, good boy. And as I like to do it, we start by parts. So first I take the paws and then I go to the body. Good boy, Bruno. But see there, he let me kind of brush him. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. I'm sure he'll get used to it. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. But he should be getting his grooming soon, so he needs to get used to his paws and... Okay, so since he just doesn't let me brush his paws, let's do a massage exercise for the paws. And that way he'll get used to being handled and eventually brushed and combed. Come on, Bruno. Here we go again. I'm not gonna brush you this time. Good boy. So from the elbow, this is the elbow, you start pressing, doing little presses. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Yes. Up onto the paws, to the toes. Good boy. Oh, that's a good boy. He's doing really good. Good boy, Bruno. Want a treat? Want a treat? Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Once he lets you touch his toes, make sure you put your fingers in between their toes. And massage. Good boy, Bruno. Yes, good boy. Good boy. Yes, good boy. Usually you touch the toes for negative things like clipping their nails or dematting the paws. Good boy. So if you get them used to touching their toes just for a regular puppy massage, it'll make the grooming experience easier. Okay, Bruno, okay. And this is a good example of a regular puppy that doesn't like to be touched. And many doodles are like this. They don't like to be handled. Good boy. Good boy. Okay, so the ears. You're gonna press the ears from the bottom, from the base to the tip of the ears. Good boy. Your treat. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Now he knows what good boys mean. Good boy means. So he'll expect a treat every time he hears the word good boy. Good boy. Yes. Good, good boy. You see how I'm pressing the ear from the base of the ear to the tip. Good boy, Bruno. Let's try the other ear. Good boy, Bruno. You can try this at home. Good boy, Bruno. Bruno, sit. Good. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Yes, good boy. Bruno, good boy. He's so hungry, he'll do whatever, anything I ask him for a treat. Bruno, sit. 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 Sit, Bruno. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. I don't know if you can see it from the camera, but I'm touching his paws. You want to go touch the tail, touch the back paws, everything. You want them to get used to being touched everywhere, because that way their experience at the vet, at the grooming, will be much positive, much more positive for them. Good boy, Bruno. Good boy. I'm not gonna keep brushing him, but we'll try again next Thursday at 6:30. I expect you to record those videos, try all these exercises at home. I know we couldn't brush as much today, but if you have any doubts about how to brush your dog properly, please come back next Thursday and we'll do some more exercises. Next week we should do more walking exercises with the leash next time, and some more brushing, and maybe we'll start with spay, depending on how Bruno is working. Are you ready, Bruno? Are you done? Well, thank you so much, and thank you for supporting small businesses. If you're not from, if you're not from Tampa, or if you are and you have a small business, a grooming shop next to you, please support them. They're all doing an awesome job at trying to treat your dog with the best, with lots of love. Thank you.